Welcome to the Heidelberg Engineering Academy. I'm Jocelyn Gageway, and I'll be moderating today's session. Please note that your phone lines have been muted to prevent any feedback. If you have questions during the presentation, please use the embedded chat feature at any point. Topical questions will be addressed if there is time at the end. Otherwise, they will be addressed by chat or email. With that, I'd like to begin today's presentation, Multicolor and OCT, Complementary Tools in Glaucoma Management, presented by Dr. Sanjay Asrani.
Multicolor and OCT, Complementary Tools in Glaucoma Management. We typically assess the presence of glaucoma using a peripapillary measurement using OCT, where we measure around the optic nerve and the display of the nerve fiber layer thickness shows us, compared to the normative database, a drop in the thickness inferiorly in both the eyes of this one patient, as shown by the black arrow. The color pictures of this patient also demonstrate the nerve fiber layer defects very easily, as pointed out by the white arrows. However, the relative ease with which you can see the nerve fiber layer defects in this patient is not always the case in many of our glaucoma patients. So we need something that will help us identify nerve fiber layer defects with ease, that helps us confirm the clinical impression as well as the OCT findings. Here is a case where in the right eye of this patient, there is a very localized nerve fiber layer defect in the right eye, which is pointed out by the red arrow here. The OCT in the right eye shows a decrease of the measurement, but it gets averaged out in the quadrant thicknesses. Therefore, one has to be sure what we are seeing, is it a real nerve fiber layer defect or not? So therefore, multicolor imaging can enhance the picture that we get, not only to help us confirm, but also to be able to demonstrate it to our patients. So what exactly is multicolor? Multicolor is the combination of three different laser wavelengths, the blue, the green, and the red. The direction of imaging goes from anterior to posterior, or inner retinal layers to outer retinal layers. So the blue light is able to image the inner retinal layers, the green light, the inner to middle retinal layers, and the red light, the outer retinal layers. And when we combine the three, we are able to see a multicolor image. This is the combination of the three different laser wavelengths. Multicolor imaging allows us to see exquisite detail of the various tissue layers that has not been possible up till now. This is a multicolor image of two retinas that you can see details that we could only see with black and white nerve fiber layer photography. In fact, the details of the nerve fiber layer are so exquisite that one can see individual axon bundles that are emanating from the horizontal raphe. The advantage of this is in patients like this one, where the patient has large cups, making this patient a glaucoma suspect. But thankfully, the nerve fiber layer is normal in both the eyes, suggesting that this sort of cupping is most likely not pathological, but physiologic cupping. Being able to visualize the nerve fiber layer in the supero and inferotemporal bundles without the presence of a nerve fiber layer loss or defect gives us tremendous confidence in being able to say that this is a normal and healthy optic nerve. Here is an example of a large cup in a patient with multiple pores of the lamina cribrosa being visible, making this patient a high-risk glaucoma suspect. However, a normal nerve fiber layer, inferotemporally and superotemporally, along with the nasal and temporal quadrants, show us that this is also physiologic cupping. Another example where there seems to be a notch in the lamina cribrosa in a large cup, which is deep as well, shows us that indeed there is no nerve fiber layer loss corresponding to that area, confirming that this patient is still having physiologic cupping. This is what a normal macula looks like in an individual that is young with bright reflections from the internal limiting membrane, including the ability to visualize the vascularization that is normal in the perifoveal area. Here are some typical examples of nerve fiber layer losses seen in patients with early glaucoma. Here is an example of the same eye shown in multicolor with an inferotemporal nerve fiber layer loss, and on the green reflectance, because the imaging allows us to not only get multicolor, but also the separate components of the imaging. So one can see with green reflectance, blue reflectance, and infrared. So in the green reflectance, one can confirm very easily the nerve fiber layer defect inferotemporally. Here is an example of a patient with bilateral inferior nerve fiber layer losses, and one can clearly see the edge of the loss in both the eyes. One can also notice that in both the eyes, superotemporally, there are isolated losses of the nerve fiber layer that are not yet extending to the disc margin. This is a case example in which this right eye of this patient has what the measurement classified as borderline nerve fiber layer. One can see that there is a slight loss inferiorly that barely reaches the abnormal range according to the normative database. To confirm this, we would use a macular thickness map that shows us the inferotemporal groove that is present in the total retinal thickness, as well as loss of the ganglion cell population inferotemporally. And one can be doubly sure with the help of the multicolor that shows us the inferior loss, as well as the green reflectance that shows us this loss very clearly. This is an example of a patient who had a normal classified nerve fiber layer thickness in both the eyes, right eye and left eye. However, in the macular thickness maps, it became obvious that the right eye thickness was lesser compared to the left eye thickness. We weren't sure if this is a pathology or is this normal, but the multicolor imaging confirmed for us that there is inferior loss of the nerve fiber layer in this quadrant, confirmed again with the green reflectance. One can also see superotemporally in the green reflectance some early losses of nerve fiber layer thickness. This is a case example of an abnormal OCT nerve fiber layer thickness and abnormal macular thickness, but a normal appearing optic nerve, a cupped disc in the right eye being only 0.2 and in the left eye being a 0.3. But the multicolor confirms for us that this loss that we are seeing in the OCT in the superotemporal quadrant of the nerve fiber layer and on the macular thickness maps is present superotemporally on the green reflectance as well as on the multicolor imaging. This is a patient who was being evaluated for an epiretinal membrane who was incidentally diagnosed with glaucoma by a retina specialist because he had the luxury of viewing this on multicolor. And on multicolor, though the epiretinal membrane is clearly visible, there is also a very clearly visible nerve fiber layer defect extending up to the optic nerve. So even though the OCT thickness in a case like this may not be very affected because of the epiretinal membrane's coexisting pathology, the ability to view on multicolor allows us to diagnose coexisting diseases. One can see that inferotemporally in the green reflectance, as well as on the OCT, there is a slight dip, but it doesn't reach the abnormal range because of the thickness being artificially higher due to the presence of the epiretinal membrane. This is an example of a patient with papilledema. In patients with chronic papilledema, it is not easy to detect when the chronic papilledema is now going to result in optic atrophy because thickness is higher than normal, significantly higher than normal. And when optic atrophy takes place, the thickness may not decrease. So measurements of OCT may not significantly change. The only tool we have in patients like this is the visual field to detect onset of optic atrophy. But now with the multicolor, one can start seeing losses of the nerve fiber layer away from the optic disc as seen here in the left eye of this patient. This is an example of another epiretinal membrane patient, again incidentally diagnosed with glaucoma on multicolor. This patient with an epiretinal membrane and a lamellar hole was being evaluated by a retina specialist when they noticed that the reflectance of the nerve fiber layer thickness superiorly was different than the reflectance inferiorly. And one can see this dark band here, this inferior portion shows loss of nerve fiber layer thickness, despite the absence of cupping in the optic nerve. And when one takes a cross-section through that area, one can see the losses of the nerve fiber layer and ganglion cells in this region that is seen below the surface. But we would not know to look for these early losses had we not seen the multicolor image. This is an example of an abnormal nerve fiber layer thickness due to, however, a retinal scar of a salmon patch in a patient who was thought to have glaucoma, but because of the wide view, one was able to see that this nerve fiber layer defect was due to retinal atrophy in the superotemporal quadrant, which may have been the location of a previous salmon patch hemorrhage in a patient with sickle cell disease. And here is a patient who has almost no cupping, a small nerve in whom diagnosis of glaucoma is tougher because of the absence of cupping. But on multicolor imaging, one can clearly see that there is a loss of nerve fiber layer, which is close to fixation, inferiorly. One can see that on green reflectance as well as on multicolor. And in the other eye of this patient, one can see an inferotemporal loss as well as a very clear-cut superotemporal loss of the nerve fiber layer. So in conclusion, glaucoma diagnosis is made a lot easier with multicolor confirmation of either clinical findings or OCT findings. Confirmation of absence of glaucoma by visualizing normal nerve fiber layer is possible using multicolor. Diagnosis of coexisting pathologies is easier using multicolor. And demonstration and education of the disease process to the patients is possible with a wow factor. Thank you very much.
Thank you for attending this presentation of the Heidelberg Engineering Academy. This course has been recorded and will be viewable on heidelbergengineering.com. On behalf of all of us here at Heidelberg Engineering, thank you again and have a wonderful day.